John Scala.
As we talk about, I'm going to talk about the temperatures in just a second, but I want to show you what the effect of the wind is here in Gettysburg. Blowing the grass around here in Adams County. You can see a little bit of snow there beneath that the grass that's waving around. That has been providing some amazing wind chills today. Our temperatures continue to plummet, and when you get up tomorrow morning, expect those wind chills to be minus 5 to minus 10. Really cold air here, but nothing like what they're experiencing in the upper Midwest. Minus 46 this morning, International Falls. Now, as you look at these numbers, keep in mind the average high is 37. The average low is 23 this time of the year. 21 degrees right now across the lower valley from Harrisburg to Lancaster over to Coatesville. 20 in Thomasville, just down the street from York. And as we look up towards the northwest, yeah, State College coming in at 15. A few of those scattered snow showers around, but they are dwindling fast, primarily up into the valley and ridge. For us, the skies are breaking up for the most part. We'll see a mix of sun and clouds as we move through the evening hours. Right now, it's 21 degrees with that wind chill of 8, and the winds continue to be out of the west at about 15 miles per hour. It may gust at times to 20 to 25 miles per hour as our temperatures drop into the upper teens this evening. Now, as I said, overnight, we may see some single digits across the valley. That would drive our wind chills overnight into the minus 5 to minus 10 degree category, despite the fact that the winds will actually be diminishing. We'll get rid of the 15 to 20, be more like 5 to 10. Tomorrow, some morning sunshine giving way to some afternoon clouds. We'll still have this issue of blowing snow around. That's going to reduce visibility, particularly if you're driving on the north to south routes. That will also drive snow across the roads and perhaps lead to some slippery conditions. You can see the storm is now pulled well off towards the northeast, and there's that break in the cloud cover that I was talking about across most of the Central Valley. Still some snow coming down towards the northwest and up an effect of the lake effect region coming off of Lake Erie, which is mostly ice covered at this point, but we're still getting a little lake effect snow in Erie at this hour, 21 in Harrisburg, 27 up in Boston, and a cold 9 degrees over in Dayton, Ohio. Well, the predictive model underplaying the cloud cover, as you can see, but you get the idea it's kind of breaking up over us. As we move into Saturday, I think we'll see partly to mostly sunny skies in the morning, and as we look through the afternoon and into the evening hours, a weak storm system moving across the upper Great Lakes will drag in some clouds through the overnight and maybe some light snow or snow showers well to the north and west of Harrisburg. And that will move through quickly as we look ahead into Sunday, some morning sunshine, and I think a partly sunny afternoon, but we're still dealing with some very cold temperatures, much below average for this time of the year. So looking at Saturday's high of 18, 10 degrees Sunday morning, and as we look ahead towards Monday, 6 degrees, likely the coldest temperature in 2 years across the lower valley. And we are keeping our eyes very close on a potential winter storm coming in Tuesday and Wednesday. So stay with us over the weekend. We'll have more details on that storm.